My name is Dr. Pai. I wrote a critically acclaimed book called An Inflammation Nation. It's the what I consider the 10-step definitive guide of preventing, reversing, and treating all disease. And I want to talk about a little bit about my background today. I'm going to talk about what is inflammation, some of the problems with our healthcare system of why we have a lot of this inflammation, some of the problems of our food industry of why we have the inflammation as well. Don't mean to be political, but sometimes I will get political because we're in a political state of mind right now. And I want to then give a little bit of aspects of what can we do in addition to the diet in terms of when we interview a patient from an integrated perspective of how to look for even food sensitivities. How do we look at nutrient levels? How do we look at your microbiome? How do we strengthen your immune system? And how do we lower inflammation using natural therapies? And if I have time, I'll try to cover some of the other steps in my book. So my journey begins actually at the age of 2, when I had my first near-death experience. And I've had many since. And that started when I was age of 2. My parents, coming home from a long day of work, they stopped by their local farm. And my dad picked up a bag of peanuts. And as we're in the kitchen, my mom was cooking some dinner. My dad was sitting on the table, put me on the table. And he was shelling some peanuts. And everybody was eating the peanuts after work. Within a few minutes, they started noticing that my eyes started to swell up, and it became the size of oranges, and my lips started turning a little light blue type color. My throat started to close up, and I basically fell over. And my dad, luckily being a great physician as he is, he took me immediately to the emergency room, and thankfully I lived in a small town, so the hospital wasn't that far away. They took me to the emergency room, and they gave me epinephrine, they gave me steroids, they put me on a ventilator, intubated, and that was able to save my life. I had a severe anaphylactic reaction to a food. At the same time, though, so Western medicine saves my life. At the same time, at the age of 2, I started to develop this chronic eczema. And it was a very bad eczema. So bad, it almost looked like psoriasis. I got these really bad plaques all over my body and neck and arms. And that plagued me throughout my life. In fact, it started in not only since age of 2, but when I started to play soccer in my elementary school, I'd wear long sleeve shirts and long socks. That plagued me all the way through high school, all the way through college, all the way through medical school, all the way to residency, and even fellowship program. Okay, and then in 2009, as a late bloomer as I would say, in turning into the plant-based diet and plant-based world, I read the book, The China Study, which Dr. Colin Campbell will be here later this week, which I recommend everybody to attend. And he's been a big influence because his book had the definitive study of looking at kind of diet and lifestyle interventions on a large population. And that data was so impressive to me because I'm an evidence-based person. You'll know if you read my book, 400 pages with 1,500 references of scientific studies and investigative journalism, I like data, and so I actually took the effort to take the course at Cornell before it was even a CME course. I said, I just want to learn more about it. So me and my partner, Maureen and I, we took the course, and after we read the book and then we finished the course of looking at all the 8,000 data points of why, you know, diet and how diet affects health, we said, let's go plant-based. So interesting enough, within 2 weeks of going on a whole food plant-based diet, my eczema disappeared. Completely, okay? Now, this was shocking because, you know, throughout my training, you know, when I finished my fellowship in 2002, and, you know, Stephen mentioned all my backgrounds of all the different various treatments and modalities that I've studied, and I've traveled across to India and other countries and had world training with experts in herbalism medicine and Ayurvedic medicine and Chinese medicine and acupuncture and homeopathy. Everything that I would use for my eczema from a conventional standpoint, from dermatologists, allergists, immunologists, was just symptomatic treatment, right? Here's a salve, or here's a steroid, or here's an immunosuppressive drug, or antihistamine, and it would help partly for a while, but as long as I stopped taking the product, I would still flare, okay? And they had many side effects that I was trying to avoid as well. Same thing with the natural products. I would take an herb, I would take a homeopathic, I would, you know, a salve or a potion, as we call it, or a lotion, as you want to call it, and that would calm the eczema down, but if I stopped using it, I would flare again. So within 2 weeks of a plant-based diet, it went away. So this led me to understand, like, well, there's something there that's in the diet that's triggering eczema. We know eczema is an inflammatory response. But it wasn't so important that it was something miraculous to me, is that we missed the concept in Western medicine of my acute care was wonderfully perfect, and I still carry an EpiPen, and we still like people to go to the hospital for acute care. But this led me to look at, well, what has it affected to not only me, but also my patients' chronic conditions. right? Because everybody has chronic inflammatory responses. So in this review of like, well, what is causing this? This led me to take this journey. And this is what led me to write the book and let me develop a product actually that's supportive, is that I had to go further.